president is the one.
Cop. I thought just from beyond the visual, I thought it was a great way to just celebrate them, let them walk through campus, and just be safe. And they are about to graduate.
Oh, boy. How far did you have to walk, man?
Oh, I'd have to walk this far. No.
Now you're getting your steps in today. Yeah, they're getting pumped now.
This one's for you, Mama.
Up, 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 up.
What up, though? Yeah.
You made
2022,
it.
Made it through.
Thank you.
for today's commencement exercise. As a courtesy to all joining us today in person, let me remind you to please silence all electronic devices at this time. Enjoy the ceremony.
It gives me great pleasure to present Coppin State University's faculty from the College of Arts and Sciences and Education, faculty from the College of Behavioral and Social Sciences, faculty from the College of Business, and faculty from the College of Health Professions.
Thank you.
the presentation of colors and the singing of the national anthem. The colors will be presented by the Coppin State University United States Army or ROTC Color Guard.
Good morning, Coppin. Please be seated. I am Anthony Jenkins. I have the honor of serving as president of this incredible institution. And on behalf of the administration, our faculty, staff, students, and alumni, I would like to extend a very special welcome to the class of 2022. Congratulations. And I'm delighted to see so many of our family and friends and supporters who are here with us today as we celebrate these incredible individuals. And those watching via live stream, welcome. It's great to have you on our beautiful campus. And before we get into celebrating these incredible Eagles, there are a few people on the platform party that I would like to acknowledge. So as your name is called, please stand, and I ask that the audience hold their applause until all names have been called. Regent Michael Gill, Grand Marshal Dr. Ronald Williams, Mrs. Angela Galliano, Chief of Staff, Dr. Erica Covington, President of the Faculty Senate, Dr. Leonte Lewis, Vice Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs, Dr. Ahmed Elagon, Chief Information Officer and Vice President for Information Technology, Mr. Steve Danik, Vice President for Administration and Finance, Mr. Joshua Humber, Vice President for Institutional Advancement, Dr. Mary Owens Southall, Dean of the School of Graduate Studies and Interim Dean for the College of Arts, Sciences, and Education, Dr. Beverly O'Brien, Dean of the College of Behavioral and Social Sciences, Dr. Sadie Gregory, Dean of the College of Business, Dr. Tracy Murray, Dean of the College of Health Professions, Mrs. Letitia Madry, President of the Coppin State University National Alumni Association, Mr. Justin Evans, President of the Student Government Association, Ms. Karen Barlin, Registrar and Director of Records and Registration, and Mrs. Gillen Hallman, Assistant Registrar, Dr. Sanithia Green, President of our Adjunct Faculty Senate, and of course, we want to acknowledge our distinguished keynote speaker, Deputy Commissioner Cherie Briscoe. We would also like to acknowledge the Baltimore Police Department Commissioner Michael Harrison. So please join me in welcoming our platform party to Coppin State University. Graduates, today, you will earn the right to be members of a very special group of individuals who have helped shape this university. The Coppin State University alumni. Will all alumni who are with us today please stand? The alums wearing gold, the class of 1972, are celebrating 50 years of soaring. Those wearing silver are celebrating 50 plus years. And those wearing black are celebrating less than 50 years, but they are well on their way to meeting the previous mentioned milestones. The years represented include 1945, 1958, 1977, 1980, 1982, 1987, 1988, 1992, 1994, 1997, 2002, 2007, 2012, and 2017. Let's give them all a thunderous Eagle round of applause. And if there are any additional special guests, public or elected officials who are with us in the audience please stand and be recognized. And last but not least, it is my honor to always acknowledge our First Lady and my incredibly beautiful wife, Toinette. At this time, Regent Gill, a member of the University System of Maryland Board of Regents, will share a message with you, followed by greetings from Dr. Erica Covington, President of the Faculty Senate, and President Justin Evans, President of the Student Government Association. Regent Gill.
Good morning.
This is not a bad way to spend a Friday morning, is it? Congratulations to all of you. And on behalf of the University System of Maryland and the Board of Regents, I'm really here to represent the system, the regents, and to congratulate all of you for this awesome, awesome accomplishment. I'd also like to recognize Deputy Commissioner Briscoe. I had a chance to meet her this morning. She's unbelievable. City College grad and a Coppin State Eagle. And my new best friend, President Anthony Jenkins, who's doing a tremendous job. He came on in May of 2020. Wasn't exactly perfect timing, but he absolutely steered this great ship through the waters. And when and he ought to have a couple more names added to his title of president. He ought to be general and commander, because we got right through the last couple years and we're in a great place today. And I love all the various partnerships that are happening at Coppin State. I don't believe there's ever been as many great partnerships. I love the fact that we have an individual named Chad Williams who wakes up in the morning, and I might name him the mayor of North Avenue because his mission is revitalization of North Avenue. So, whoop, look at that. I got that flag all fired up. But Chad Williams and what he's working to do. The partnerships with the community colleges, so important to us. The partnership with Charles Schwab. I think that's so cool, the College of Business, and being able to do some neat things around learning the investment world, things along the BGE Scholars. STEM's a big deal. And people don't say, yeah, I want to support that because I'm supposed to. They believe in Coppin, and that's why they're supporting these initiatives. And the funding, we've never been in a better position for greatness than today at Coppin State University, with so many new resources financially coming into the institution. A couple last thoughts to share with you. President Jenkins and I were together recently at a Regents meeting, and we started talking about the theme of best is the standard. And we brought it right back to Coppin being what is Coppin's best. We're not there yet, but that's what we aspire to be. Best is the standard. And then what is your best? Not your best relative to somebody else, your very best. And when you identify what it is, give it, do it every day. Every day, not just maybe Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays. I don't really read a lot of poems, but there is one poem that sticks in my head constantly. It's Robert Frost, The Road Less Traveled. And there's this expression towards the end of it. And it says, two roads diverged in the woods, and I took the one less traveled. And that has made all the difference. So here's a couple thoughts as you leave here today, because this is really cool. This is your day. Tomorrow, it's back to work. But today, it's your day. Take risks. Don't be risk averse. Take risks in your life. It's the two roads, and you take the one that everybody else didn't take. Stay close to your family. I don't care how many good friends you have. You'll never have any better friends than your family. And they're all here today to celebrate you. Push the negative people out of your life. They ain't going anywhere. And you're eagles. You're soaring. So congratulations to all of you. Have a beautiful day and go Eagles.
Good morning, class of 2022. On behalf of the faculty here at Coppin State University, let me be the first to say it is done. All of the hard work, all of the days and nights of studying while trying to manage jobs, being caregivers, parenting, COVID, and many other obstacles that you have faced, you have persevered. And now, as you sit here in anticipation of receiving your degree, I ask that you take in these words. Nothing worthwhile comes easy. If it did, everyone would do it. With that being said, I'd like to share a poem with you that I wrote entitled Persevere. If life only brought you pleasure, how would you handle pain without lessons and values to gain? Your journey through life is like a long traveled road with bumps and curves and direction untold. As we search for happiness and success in all we do, can you be sure that you are open to the failures, burdens, and negativity that often avails to take you off your journey's destined trail? Live your life as if is never guaranteed. So try in all that you do to create your positive influence for all to see. Coppin State University graduating class of 2022, congratulations. Go forth and soar and know that you have been equipped and prepared to impact change and pave the way to the future. Best wishes and go make Coppin proud. Thank you.
Jenkins, administration, members of faculty, students, our eminent graduates, class of 2022, good morning and welcome. It is my superb pleasure to welcome you all to Coppin State University's 2022 commencement ceremony. Today, you represent yourselves proudly in front of everyone. It's appropriate to stand back, take a breath, and realize how far you've come today, not just transformed physically, but mentally and emotionally as well. No one understands that after a certain amount of time you had to run on your own energy. You had to convince yourself you were gonna make it regardless of what life was throwing at you. I'm here to tell you to take a breath and take this moment in. Take this moment in for the process you went through and how much you had to believe in yourself in order to be here today. You have truly accumulated priceless moments that will remain close to your hearts and close to your minds for a lifetime. Our people and our culture have stirred the soul of America because it comes from the heart. A very sincere thank you to Dr. Anthony Jenkins, administration, honored guests, members of faculty, staff, workers, students, and everyone who plays a part in making this Black institution thrive. I am Justin Evans, president of the Student Government Association, and it's been an honor. Thank you and congratulations. God bless and go Eagles.
Thank you, Regent Gill, President Covington, and President Evans, for your remarks. It is my pleasure to introduce our commencement speaker. Her expanded biography is provided in the printed program. It's crazy. But I would like to share just all a few highlights. Deputy Commissioner Cherie Briscoe is a 27-year veteran of the Baltimore Police Department. Beginning as a patrol officer in the city's Western District, Deputy Commissioner Briscoe has risen through the ranks of the Baltimore City Police Department and is a proud graduate of Coppin State University, where she earned a bachelor's degree in criminal justice. She is the first African-American woman promoted to the rank of Deputy Commissioner for Baltimore Police Department. She currently oversees the Operations Bureau, which includes the divisions of patrol, criminal investigation, and data-driven strategies. She has implemented community outreach and engagement strategies to focus on relationship building and community-centered policy. In 2016, she was named one of Baltimore's change makers by CBS News. And she is known for her direct, compassionate, and nonsense leadership. No nonsense leadership, that is. That promotes relationship building in the community. And she believes that we do that by one encounter at a time. She is an amazing individual who continues to do amazing things. And would you all please join me in welcoming Coppin State University alumnae, Deputy Commissioner Cherie Briscoe.
Good morning, Coppin State University, but most importantly, good morning, graduating class of 2022. Thank you so much, Dr. Jenkins, for this opportunity to address this amazing group of Eagles. It is truly my privilege, my pleasure, and my honor to join you today. Mr. Gill from the Board of Regents, our conversation walking up truly calmed my spirit, so thank you for that. To the administration, faculty, and staff, it is certainly my honor to be before you today. In such a time as this, where many are defined by their appearance, political affiliations, social groups, relationship status, social media posts, professional interests, and professional assignments, I found it mysteriously odd that in my inbox will be an invitation from President Jenkins asking me if I would do the honor of being this year's keynote speaker. Humbled and elated, my first response was not an immediate yes. My first response instead was one of reflection, angst, nervousness, so much so that I paused. Simultaneously, my phone rang. On the other end was Lindsay Eldridge, our public information officer for the agency. Knowing exactly who I am, Lindsay called to gauge my interest in the invitation, and the first thing she said to me, "Before you tell me a reason why you shouldn't, let me tell you why you should." In that moment, it was just as if God was listening to my inner voice and sent Lindsay to affirm what I needed to hear. After I hung up the phone, my sister cousin, Kenyatta, because you know how we do. Come on now, I'm from Baltimore. I am of Coppin. Okay. I am not a transplant. Okay. So in a minute, I'm gonna get off of this page and I'm gonna talk to you like only we can from this place. But my sister cousin, I called her. I told her about the exciting opportunity and the hesitance that lied in my spirit. She hung up the phone, FaceTimed me to look me in my eyes, and she said, girl, are you crazy? She hollered beyond me in the distance to my husband, Dante, who is here with me today. Thank you, husband, for always being my cheerleader, always standing by my side, and always praying for me and holding me up. He said, I know, you know your cousin. She's special. After a chuckle and a laugh, she looked at me and said, Cherie, you have something special to share. You have something special to say. Share your testimony. Share your story. Share yourself. Because someone, whether they are seated in the audience or watching from afar, will need to hear what you have to say. Because someone is doubting themselves and what they bring to this opportunity of life and to this table we call living. Cobbinites, be the answer. You see, in this place of insecurity and fear, that's where our hesitance steps in. And a question is asked of us, and our immediate response isn't a yes. Because something in us doubts our ability, doubts what we bring. All of a sudden, you will see your insecurity and your fears showing up, because your mind will take you to a place where you failed, where you fumbled, where you've fallen short. And you would think that you don't have what it takes. I'll say to you, don't sit there. Be the answer. So again, Dr. Jenkins, I thank you for seeing me from afar and extending the invitation to address my beloved Cobbin family. As a recent Cobbin graduate of the class of 2020, I am a proud product of Baltimore City. I am a proud product of the Baltimore City school system, and I am a proud product of Coppin State University. With that, I say all of that to say, I know I am amongst family. So being amongst family, please allow me to sit down all of the words on the page in your program that start with the title Deputy Commissioner, and just allow me for a moment to be Cherie. Because in being Cherie, I want to share with you things that people may not know, care little about, or refuse to see. See, this journey didn't start just a few years ago when I joined the Baltimore Police Department, or in 2020 when I graduated from Coppin State University. This journey started at the age of 15. At the age of 15, I was a 10th grader at the Baltimore City College. And though from that description in my biograph, Regent Gill, you would have assumed that I was a graduate of the City College. Though I hold it dear, I was not a graduate of it. What I was at 15, pregnant with twins, was a high school dropout. The year was 1988. That year forever changed my journey and every decision that I would make. Because at that point, the journey became more about two children than it was about me.
Not just a cop, but a commissioner.
All of my decisions from that point, I thought were going to be about the people that God granted me to have charge over. Every choice in my life was about answering a larger question. What will you now make of this life as a teenage mother? How will you provide when you have little direction, guidance, education, and a strong foundation? What will you become? All questions that would have never been answered had I quit the journey. Though difficult, to be an emancipated teenage mother, there were many key moments and key people along my journey that God saw fit to send my way to encourage me, lift me up, hold me accountable, kick me in the butt, and hold my hand. Just as I am certain, there have been many people along the way of life for each and every one of you that has been there to cheer you on. But for the village, our family members, your significant others, your professors, your big sisters and brothers, your coaches, your mentors, where would you be? When the road looks and feels impossible, and the obstacles in front of you seem insurmountable, and the naysayers and gnashers and haters are all about you, don't give in. There is something bigger, something more amazing that all of this struggle is designed for you to do. It is not designed to kill you. It is not designed to take you out. It is not designed to stop you. It is designed to help you achieve, accomplish, and complete. Someone somewhere needs you to push past your fears, past your flaws, past your faults, to be the answer. Therefore, do not quit. Nelson Mandela once said, "The greatest glory in living lies not in never falling, but in rising every time you fall." By the age of 22, I was a mother of four, still looking for my purpose in life and validation, trying to figure out the next steps when I joined the Baltimore Police Department. The year was 1994. The day, December the 6th. I remember it like it was yesterday because that was the day that I raised my right hand, swore my oath, and committed myself to a life of service for others for the sake of anybody other than myself. I had no idea what I was getting myself into. At 22 years old, walking through the campus at the time of Morgan State University, my recruiter, Mr. Tyrone Kilby, who was an officer in recruitment, engaged me in a conversation and pitched me an ideology of joining a team that I could see myself being a part of because he talked about an opportunity to serve my community while earning a wage to support myself and my family. There was something oddly interesting about the words that he shared. I could see myself joining this team, helping when one another is in need, and serving my community. Yes, I believed then, as I still do now, that service of self and sacrificing for the sake of others and community through policing is still an honorable profession, only if you do it honorably. My quest to achieve the goal of higher education started decades before I finished. A dream deferred or delayed is better than a dream abandoned. Do not quit. In the words of Dr. Martin Luther King, if you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, you must keep moving forward. I share with you these honest realities because there's someone listening, needing to hear this story, needing to get past the narrative, needing to push past the naysayers, needing to challenge him or herself. I stand before you as a testament and a product of the prayers of many and the evidence that you are able to achieve more than you dare to imagine if you just stay focused and refuse to quit. You will be faced with countless moments where you will have to gather the courage and commitment to stay the course and never give up, because someone somewhere is waiting on you to be the answer. Nothing about this journey is easy, nor should it be. The difficulty is always designed to fuel you, grow you, but most importantly, to teach you. In the difficult place, you are there, and you will be further refined, just as iron can only sharpen iron. There, you will learn to remain positive, become consistent, become resilient, increase your faith, walk in humility, embrace empathy, and rally your commitment for the journey to grow. All of these attributes you will need to get beyond the moment, and most importantly, to be the answer. As a lifestyle and profession of service, I've made my commitment to giving back to the community in which I serve, the community in which that birthed me, and the community in which I live. All of which you must ask yourself, do you have what it takes for this journey of life? Don't think for 1 minute when you read a program and you see the words Deputy Commissioner aligned with the words First African American Female, do not think that it is easy. It still is a difficult road. But I say that to you to say, you must not quit. And the journey here in this moment, though a celebration, is not the end. You have more to give. You have more to do. And you have more to learn. I assure you, you are not alone. And yes, you are the right person for the assignment. So when you hear your haters, your naysayers, and your gnashers, your backbiters, your talkabouts, your people that don't like you, those people that dislike you, hide you on social media, talk about you, when you hear them, just snap your fingers. Know you are doing something right. God is about to move. You are on the right road. The assignment is yours. You're equipped for the job. You are in the right position. You need to cheer yourself on. You are your only cheerleader. You are all you need. You are who is sent. And you are more than a conqueror. You are who God says. You are highly favored. You are created in the image of greatness. You are more than enough. And you are all that is needed. Every great dream begins with a dreamer. Always remember, you have within you the strength, the patience, the passion to reach for the stars and change the world. So said Harriet Tubman. The hardest part of this journey is turning your dreams into reality. Your presence here signifies that today you are fully committed to the assignment. So align your thoughts, your conversation, your actions to achieve your goals. Use the challenge, the disappointments, the long days, and the difficult nights to be your fuel for the journey. And always remember that whatever you endeavor, love wins when everything else will fail. So said Fannie Jackson Cotton. If no one else tells you today, you are loved, you are appreciated, you are a dream realized, you are the answer to a prayer, you are the unexpected solution, you are the way out of no way, you are the forbearer, the foregrower, you are the answer. Why? Because you are the alumni of Coppin State University. You are an eagle, so go soar.
Coppin, let's give our keynote speaker another thunderous round of applause. Deputy Commissioner Briscoe, if you would join me at the podium, please. So as a proud graduate of Coppin State University, and throughout a 27-year career with the Baltimore Police Department, Sheree Briscoe has developed and honored and honed her skills and is an expert in helping foster better relationships between the police department and the community that she serves. There is no reward that we could give you to show our appreciation for all the things that you've done. And your message today, I am confident that someone is taking something away. It filled their spirit. It gave them wind beneath their wings. And so, in honor of you and all of your great accomplishments, I am presenting to you this crystal eagle. May it always bring you joy. And when you reflect on it, you think about what you did here today and what you have accomplished thus far in your life. Because today, you've empowered a generation and those to come that you will never get the opportunity to meet. And that is the true essence of what Coppin is about, making a difference and transforming lives. Thank you.
All graduates of Coppin State University are unique in their own way. On this occasion, it is particularly appropriate that we recognize those students who have earned their doctoral degrees. Will the candidates for the Doctor of Nursing Practice please stand? President Jenkins, the following candidates have fulfilled the requirements as set forth by the Dean of the School of Graduate Studies and the Dean and the Faculty of the College of Health Professions. I am pleased to present them for the degree, for the conferring of their degree.
With the recommendation of the Dean of the School of Graduate Studies and the Dean and Faculty of the College of Health Professions and the Provost, by the authority vested in me, by the Board of Regents for the University System of Maryland, I hereby confer upon each of you the Doctor of Nursing Practice degree as appropriate, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. Congratulations. Will the candidates please come forward?
graduate or a U.S. doctor. Will the candidates for the master's degree please rise? President Jenkins, the following candidates have fulfilled all the requirements as set forth by the Dean of the School of Graduate Studies and the Deans and the Faculty of the College of Arts, Sciences and Education, the College of Behavioral and Social Sciences, the College of Health Professions. I am pleased to present them to you for the conferring of their degrees. Master of Arts in Teaching, Master of Education in Contemporary Educational Leadership, Master of Education in Curriculum and Instruction, Master of Science in Adult and Continuing Education, Master of Education in Rehabilitation Counseling, Master of Science in Criminal Justice and Law Enforcement, Master of Science in Addiction Counseling, Master of Science in Human Services Administration, and Master of Science in Nursing.
With the recommendation of the Dean of the School of Graduate Studies, the Dean and Faculty of the College of Arts, Sciences and Education, the College of Behavioral and Social Sciences, and the College of Health Professions, and the Provost, by the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of the University System of Maryland, I hereby confer upon each of you the master's degree by which you have earned, as appropriate with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. Congratulations, graduates. Please proceed to the stage. Edgerton. Corinne Bland. Thank you.
Kathleen Green Kaysen. Akiva Johnson. Marquita Pritchett. Walton. Idowu Adeleke. Thank you.
Congratulations. I would like to take this time to acknowledge our graduates who have earned special academic achievement. Those graduates who are wearing honor cords have distinguished themselves during their academic career and are worthy of such recognition. I'd like to first acknowledge our distinguished Eagle Award winner, Miss Chandra Little. Please note on pages 14 to 16 of your program, those students who are members of honor societies. To be eligible membership in a university honor society, a student must submit that society's specific requirement for eligibility. Honor society students, congratulations on your commitment to academic excellence, and we thank you for the national and international recognition that you bring to Coppin State University by your membership in these societies. Members are also identified by wearing pins and sashes representative of their society. I also call your attention to those students whose academic performance is reflected in their cumulative grade point averages. Bachelor's degree candidates who have attained a cumulative grade point average of between 3.25 and 3.49 will graduate cum laude. Please stand and be recognized. Students who have attained a cumulative grade point average between 3.50 and 3.74 will graduate magna cum laude. Please stand and be recognized. Students who have attained a cumulative grade point average of 3.75 and above will graduate summa cum laude. Please stand and be recognized. Please join me in applauding these students for their academic accomplishments. Most of you have been waiting for. Will the candidates for the bachelor's degree from the College of Arts, Sciences, and Education please stand? Will the candidates for the bachelor's degree from the College of Behavioral and Social Sciences please stand? Will the candidates for the bachelor's degree from the College of Business please stand? Will the candidates for the bachelor's degree from the College of Health Profession please stand? President Jenkins, the following candidates have fulfilled all the requirements for the bachelor's degree in which they have earned set forth by the deans and faculty of the College of Arts, Sciences, and Education, the College of Behavioral and Social Sciences, the College of Business, and the College of Health Professions. I am pleased to present them to you for the conferring of their degrees.
Thank you, Provost. With the recommendation of the dean and faculty of the College of Arts, Sciences, and Education, the College of Behavioral and Social Sciences, the College of Business, and the College of Health Professions, and the Provost, by the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of the University System of Maryland, I hereby confer upon you the bachelor's degree as appropriate with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. At this time, it is customary that you move your tassel from right to left. To signify that you have earned your baccalaureate degree, congratulations, Eagles. Marshals, please bring these graduates to the stage.
Monique Pittman. University, Desiree Jones. Desiree Carrizosa. Jamasia Selman. Alexis Genevieve. Cooper. Deja Jones. Maya Green Worrell. Brianna Scott. Tori Bryant. Tyrone Nance Jr. Sabria Poole. Trinity Diggs. Trinity Drakes. Aaliyah Jones. Takia Bryant. Winder Cooper. Malik John. Hey. Abeye Opuni. Nathaniel Gray. Jordan Jackson. Elijah Williams. Kamaria Wakefield. Rebecca Howery. EJ Erebor. Montez Cooper. Janae Quails. Diamond Adams. Jaleesa Brown. Jasmine Dixon. Natalia Burris. Rashay Dobbins. iDreamer Monet McCafferty. Dion Marrow. Brianna Smith. Haisha Lovett. Desiree Oliver.
Yes, yes, honey.
Alicia Young. LaShawn Hinton. Kalia Hill. Jafari Butler. Jamal Alexander.
Love you, Tazzy. Yeah.
Luciana Mwangi. Yolando Anderson. Shayla Williams. Mackenzie Daniels. Megan Watson. Joseph Judah Cooper Jones. DeShandra McDonald. Michaela Dowdy. Jasmine Slide.
Johnson. Marielle Carty. Chanel Tomlinson. Alice Barnes. Dominique Speed. Cherie Turnage. Tamia Drumright. Ashania Brown. Leah Martin. Amanda Watkins. Shaprice Shears. Sandra Jones. Del Pino. Shalice Green. Tashay Drummond. Tamar Dennis. Wanda Pulliam.
Yay, Wanda!
Laban Smith. Lisa Carter Evans. Kwanye McLean. Kyra Powell. The amazing Elise McRae. Katia Barnes. LaMonica Richardson. Deshae Rasko. Shanice Barkley. Carita Stanley. Sheree Richardson. Bria Holloway Douglas. Tyera Frazier. Amber Braxton. Bria Holmes. Danielle Rigby.
Yeah!
Mongo.
Yes, Mom!
Neil Conway. Sylvia Lopez Posey. Naomi Nina. Kiara Lennon. Markia Crosby. Joshua Peterson. Isabella Zalba. Brandon Watkins. Sergio Dari Medicine.
I was about to say that sounded more like a sentence than a name.
She took her baby on stage.
Lucia Placidi.
Woo! No, no!
Taraja Laurie. Lisa Holly Oti. Sierra Nicholson. Janisha Payne.
Grace Alaquachi. Antoinette Selma. Tahira Muhammad. Marissa Alvarado. Michaela Cabarallo. Christy Turner. Abigail Weiss. Shakira Barnes. Sabrika Finch. Deshaun Butler. Archie Blunt. Gilbert McCoy Jr. Janaya Hill. Sequoia Truxon. Albert Johnson Jr. Jane Jaguar. Adeline Eleman Fierro. Narama Ba. Lynette Raymond. Dion Harris. Christia Bostic. Alicia Clark. Anikia Miller. Rochelle Johnson. Brittany McConnell. Shatira Daniel. Nakisha White. Destiny Hudgens. Lil Emma Stewart. Rodney Williams. Deja Mack. Laurel Henrique Sr. Dale James. Yolana Farrell Williams. Brittany Scott. Michelle Simmons. Tatiana Young. Lakeisha Johnson. Douglas Brown Jr. Tristan Farmer. Oluwaseun Adeniji. Aya Johnson. Sequoia Young. Brandon Nair. Trisha A. Smith. Sharmika Smith. Shalanda Brother. Kevin J. Johnson Jr. Michael Scott Jr. Alana Kennedy. Tyree Williams. Wendell Reed III. Kyle Cardacy. Sydney Hicks. Shakira Lawson. Camilla Monroe. Cynthia Wayuma. Avis Smith. Jeffrey Coleman. September Jones. Hey, Erica Adams. Latoya Talley. Princess Anukwafor. Oluwabo Lasola Adebo Gejo. Olayinka Jim. Shedu Anyamu. Desvamarim Abrahali. Dahlia Harrison. Shamaya Johnson. Jordan Tucker. Ty Trogdon. Tori Jackson. Aaliyah Lawson. Malani Aguilera. Bianca Coates. Raven Horsey. Brittany Nicole Gregory. Olivia Dickerson. Charisse Coppin. Dontaire Whitfield. Lakia Brown. Tamia Sharday. Braswell Johnson. Shakira Samuel. Mrs. Kia Hopkins. Jennifer Leslie Adjoa Nikwe. Makia Alimatu Jola. Katina Horton. The blessed and highly favored. Kiara Simpson. Dominique Norris.
Yes, Richard! You better walk, boy! Yes,
Linda Garcia. Roy Jones Jr. Indeka Roslyn Amakiri. Rodija Smallwood. Kayla March. Catherine Lane. Claudina Udoka Constantine. Brianna Alician Bushrod. Imani Cheyenne Davies. Amber Vaughn. Ashley Corlett. Joanne Johnson. Kira Washington. Deja Moody. Deja Montgomery. Jamira Perper. Katama Oga. Daniel Sublime. Jerry Rose. Ask for me too. Gifty Opare. Karashia Thompson. Olanle Akinduse. Adedoyin Akinbade. Lois Dom. Richard Fajimolu. Lauren Newkirk. Abba Moore. Kendra Young.
Joel Henderson. Sadria Galarza. Daniel Harris. Lafisette Odubanjo. Kayla Demerit. Estora Rashid. Naya Smith. Monet Newman. Bukola Almarouf. Jacqueline Wardell. Safa. Ebony Turner. Erica Quick. Andrea Melton. Faith McCoy. Nakia Swan. Deborah Mensa. Anne Mushiri. Tamara Brown. Charlene Cooper.
class of 2022 another round of applause. The next person I bring to the podium is another one of our incredible alumni. But before I bring her to the podium, I just want to take the moment to thank our graduates. I want to thank you for staying the course. I want to thank you for your tenacity. I want to thank you for your determination. And as many of you crossed the stage, I was telling you to continue to be the example. Because nothing you do in life is more profound than that. Your actions will define the inroads that you make or that you burn. And Miss Madry is one of those individuals who lives the very essence of what Coppin State University is. She is true to her alma mater. She is committed, and she works every day to be the example. So Miss Madry, let me have you come to the podium and administer the alumni oath to our graduates.
Thank you, Dr. Jenkins. It is my honor to welcome these graduates to Coppin State University alumni family. Congratulations, class of 2022. It is humbling for me to greet you today on behalf of the National Alumni Association Executive Board and the alumni of Coppin State University. You have been prepared in excellence to achieve personal and professional goals. We are proud of your achievements and the fact that you are now the link between the rich legacy of the future of our institution and the community. We ask that you remain committed to the values and growth of Coppin State University and serve with pride and distinction as its newest graduates. I would like to acknowledge all Coppin State alumni. Would you please stand at this time? And remain standing as we induct the class of 2022 into our National Alumni Association. Graduates, please stand for the alumni oath and turn to page 22 of your commencement program and repeat after me. For all the inspiration alma mater has brought me through the years that are past. Would you guys please repeat after me? I'm going to start again. For all the inspiration alma mater has brought me through the years that are past. And for all the brightness alma mater will shed along my path in the future. Direction and meaning to my life in order that I might help others find meaning in living and serving, I am grateful. And for these gifts, I pledge everlasting loyalty, love, and devotion. Always, I shall be a faithful and active member of the Association of Alma Mater, and I shall do all within my power to support her plan. To spread her name abroad, expand her membership, and keep her first among all organizations. Congratulations on your academic achievement. May success always come your way in life. Everyone, please stand for the singing of our alma mater.
Nation, today, Dr. Leontae Lewis has presided over her final commencement as provost of this university. She has been an incredible leader and an amazing alum of Coppin State. And I ask that you join me in giving her a thunderous eagle round of applause.
Graduates, faculty, platform, party, please remain standing. Graduates and guests, we thank you, and we hope that you have enjoyed commencement, and we ask everyone present to please remain seated for the reception.